So this is the Land Rover inside after a day of heavy rainfall. Puddles in the footwells. And as you can see, it's all coming down from the hardtop. You'll just be able to see it runs out of the gutter. And it's usual to drive off on a wet day and it all runs down your right leg. Yeah, not very pleasant. So I've made a decision and I'm going over to the canvas top that I first had on it, or I had on it when I first got it. I've found that you just cannot get the hard top fully watertight, and a properly weatherproofed canvas is probably a better thing. So that's the next big job on the Land Rover. Okay, so on the inside of this roof, it's not particularly nice. It was a 50 quid job off eBay, and the back door came off a Land Rover that was rotting in the woods where I was working at the time, so that's not perfect either. It was all done on the cheap. The insulation on the roof is now all peeling. This carpet tile stuff that was on the roof is horrible. It's always wet and smelly, and as I say, it leaks terribly. The water comes in around the gutters, which is a problem with these roofs, so they do that. The gutter is riveted on, and the only way to solve it is to de-rivet, drill all the rivets and reseal it. The side windows are leaking all around the frames. The windows themselves actually leak, so when it rains hard, water just gets in everywhere, and the whole vehicle is wringing wet. So particularly in winter, it can be quite unpleasant. So I think the canvas is going to be a huge improvement. I know I've seen plenty that are much drier than this. A properly treated canvas, waterproof regularly, will be a much drier thing, and if it's fitted properly. So I'm going to take some film of doing the conversion from hardtop back to canvas. We'll of course lose the use of my roof rack, but I will hang on to that. I've got a few ideas for making that fit the soft top gutter, the frame around the windscreen. So we'll see what we can do with that. Removing the hardtop shouldn't be too big a job. There's obviously a row of bolts over the windscreen. There's these brackets along the sides of the tub. There's several of these along the sides of the tub. You've got some brackets here, one piece door seal that will have to come off, and then there's loads of bolts around the top. Because what I intend to do is actually separate the sides from the top and make it all a bit more manageable. So as you can see, a multitude of bolts to come out, and then it should just lift off. So there we are. As you can see, just a little bit of rain today, and it's full of water again. So you can imagine what it's like in winter. So it's about another 30 degree day again, and not the day to be working on cars. Having bled up the brakes on the MG, we're now having a look at stripping off the hardtop on the Land Rover and converting back to canvas. So Sam is just taking out the hardtop to side panel bolts, and we're going to take the lid off first and then the sides second. So the external sun visor has come off now to make it a little easier to get the shark tooth rail on. It's going to go back at some point. And I've taken the seals off so far as I need to. All the bolts above the windscreen are out. Sam's just doing the last ones on that side, and then we're pretty much ready to lift the lid off. And the back door's off. And I've just removed all the ties and door latches, which we don't need anymore. So the roof's now stripped off completely, sides are off, and the Land Rover's ready to accept the hood stick frame. The hoops themselves drop in, their holes will already be there to accept them. Sometimes you have to drill out the cappings, but these ones are already drilled. This vehicle had a canvas on it years ago, so it's all there already. Sun visor's off for now. I've just scraped the felt seal off the top of the screen. But we're probably going to put a strip of neoprene sticky back underneath the Shark Tooth rail on the front. Now we have all the hood sticks in place. Bit tricky getting the clearances all right around the driver's door, but we got there in the end. And the Shark Tooth rail is pretty poor quality, not greatly pleased with that, but we might be able to jimmy it into shape a bit. But yeah, it's obviously warped during the galvanising. We're about ready to throw the canvas on now. Give you a quick walk round of the Land Rover now it's got the canvas on it. First proper drive with the canvas on. The first issue is the fumes being drawn into the cab. I think we need to sort out some sort of side exit exhaust to deal with that. With the back open, you get something of a vacuum in the back, I think, and it draws the fumes in. So it could have been a better journey here, but there you go, we'll sort that out. The hood itself is quite nice, the canvas is nice. I've got to get in touch with Exmoor Trim because there is a little fault with it. So a little one. Got this detail on this side, and they've completely omitted this on the other side. I'm not quite sure what's going on there. So I need to have a chat with them, see if they'll do an exchange on the hood perhaps. The hood stick set, I have to be totally honest, all this framework, I was not so impressed with the quality of that. After a long wait, it was disappointing, and you end up with these huge gaps, and it is fitted correctly. I actually had to modify the seal lip on that to make it fit, and that was after adjusting the windscreen. There was no way the bolts were going in, so disappointing, but on the whole it is quite a nice thing, and I am pleased to have it back under canvas. Things like the buckles, the ropes, they're really nice, far better than the last canvas I had, and the actual fit is brilliant, and they really nailed that. Got a new tailgate. I looked at the prices people were asking for bent and battered ones and decided I'd just buy a new one. Reasonable quality actually, it's not too bad, so I've given it a shoddy paint job to match the rest, but I've fitted up the buffers. The only thing it hasn't got, of course, is a nice galvanised capping. I might be able to change that. And got some towgate chains, the proper fittings onto the tub, for which holes are already drilled. Yeah, I'm quite pleased with the colour as well. This is sand canvas rather than khaki this time, and it does look good. I'm going to repaint the vehicle probably grey or possibly bronze green, I'm not quite sure yet. It's a choice between the two. I think I need to sort out a side exit exhaust. It exits under the back of the vehicle, really it needs to come out out the side to get the fumes away. So I might get a new back box and then try and put a bend in it there, because this is getting pretty crusty. I could have it exiting behind the mud flap. So we'll have to play with that, see what we can do.
So there you go. Generally quite pleased with it, but there are a few problems. No doubt down to coronavirus, probably they'll blame it on that. Changes of staff and what have you, I'm sure. Something like that. But I'll have a chat with Exmoor Trim, see what they have to say for themselves. Notice the missing bit of trim. And see what they'd like to do about it. Because for the money, I think it's got to be right, you know.
But as I say, by and large, it looks good. It is actually a good fit. Some canvases are really not. And I know that's been a criticism of the Exmoor ones in the past, but this one, I think they really have nailed the fit. Anyway, so I'll update you again soon, and I better get that exhaust sorted out. But I put this piece of scrap pipe on there with a bend in it as an experiment. So the exhaust originally came out about there, just under the tub, and this gets it out into the airflow past the vehicle. And that, just that short distance, has made a massive improvement. And if the wind was in the right direction, you could just smell fumes in the cab, but otherwise it was spot on, quite bearable, you know, no problem at all. So when I've replaced the exhaust, I'm going to fit a 45 degree bend. You can get ready-made exhaust bends with swage ends so that they just kind of push onto the existing exhaust and clamp in place. So I can cut the exhaust about there and then put my 45 degree, so the exhaust will come out about there. And you see a lot of 88 soft top Land Rovers like that, and that should solve the issue. I think bringing it further back this way will make an even bigger difference. So yeah, it's surprising just what a small change can make. Otherwise, yeah, very enjoyable. Just a thing.